Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. And hi, my name is Anila Pamida Azli and my metric number is 8811454. Today, I would like to talk about introduction to a truss. A truss is a structure that leverages the triangle's inherent geometric stability to distribute weight uniformly and handle shifting tension and compression. Truss is mainly composed of a web of triangle that are connected in such a way that pressure and tension are applied to the points of each other's triangle's corner. It is to take advantage of the stability in order to support a structure. A significant amount of weight can be safely transferred to load-bearing beams, walls, or earth directly by linking a series of trusses together. The triangle utilized in the bridge are built to deal with the lateral wind. The truss design safely is Design safely distributes the uneven force that the bridge receives from the wind. A truss provides a solid structure capable of carrying significant external loads over a long span due to the fact that triangle cannot be deformed by stress. Because they require a modest amount of material for the amount of weight they can hold, trusses are preferred in bridge construction. Covered bridge, railroad bridge, and military bridge are all the examples of where they are used. A truss bridge can have its depth on top, in the center, or at the bottom of the trusses, and it is classified as a deck truss, half through truss, respectively. Next, we move on to the background case of study. A truss bridge's component elements are strained primarily in axial tension or compression. Because it bears vertical loads through bending, a single-span truss bridge is similar to a simple supported beam. Bending causes compression in the top cords, tension in the bottom cords, and either tension or compression in the vertical and diagonal components, depending on their position. For generations, truss has been utilized to assist in the construction of timber bridges and structures. Although there is no evidence of truss bridge in the ancient world, that some kind of truss bridge is illustrated in the 13th century sketchbook of French architect named Villard de Honnecourt, and four designs are documented in Andreas Palladio's treatise on architecture. Early trusses were constructed without a detailed understanding of how each component of the truss carries the loads. Squire Whipple, an American who created hundreds of minor truss bridges and published his theories in 1869, was the first to precisely assess the stresses in a truss. Understanding exactly how loads were carried resulted in a reduction in materials which had evolved from wood and stone to iron and steel at that time.
Hi, assalamualaikum. Number 8821175.
A truss is construction made out of a number of bars that are pin linked at their ends to make a solid framework. Loads and responses are often believed to be applied to the truss simply at the joint. A truss is often made out of a triangle part with the top cord bars under compression and the lower cord bars under tension. Bridge, low spun roof, power towers, and spill building all make use to the trusses. Trusses are statically determined when all of the bar forces can be calculated using the only static equation. The truss is otherwise statically undetermined. With the respect of the responses, more than 3 or 6 rations, a 2D or 3D problem respectively, a truss might be as statically determined
and indeterminate. The following assumption
are made for the truss analysis. First, bar are pre-connected. Second, frictionless hangers are used in the joint. Loads are only applied to joint. But its member stress is constant throughout its length. The goal of a truss analysis is to determine the member force and reaction. The equation of equilibrium were employed to carry out the analysis, and only element of the structure were considered with analysis. The free body
diagram to solve. Hi, move to the
first one, method of joint of truss analysis. To begin, we assume that all members are instead of a tension ration. A tension member is subject to full force on the both ends of the bar, which are easily indicated by the positive symbol. When a member is pushed at the both end, the bar is considered to be in compression mode and is level with a negative symbol. A virtual cut is produced around a joint in the joint approved, and the cut is isolated as a free body diagram. The under member forces can be solved using the equilibrium equation Fx equals 0 and Fy equals 0. All members are supposed to be a connect in the shape of the ideal bin with all the first intention, positive aspect. A thrust dancers can completely pass around with a major section under the applied forces the joint have involved into the free body in equilibrium. The equation has equal 0 and V equal 0 can be used to calculate the unknown forces in member meeting at the joint. With these two equations, it clear that no more than two unknowns may be determined at the time. At the end, a simple thrust model is supported by pin and rope support. Its triangle has the same length and equilateral, with every angle have a degree of angle of 16 degrees. By picking a point of movement and at the point A or point C, the support ratio RA and RC may be computed, whereas HA equals 0. For this strategy, here are some simple squat lines. First, create the free body diagram first. Second, figure out how to solve the ratio of the given structure. Then, choose a joint with the fewest unknown, maximum 2. And analyze it with FF equals 0, FY equals 0. Then, move on to the remaining joints, advising on those with the fewest unknown possibles.
Next, with
FX equals 0 and FY equals 0, check member forces and at NOS joint. Lastly, determine whether the member forces are in tension positive or compressive negative.
Three joints are
shown in diagram at B, C, and E. A joint or point can be used to calculate the force in each member. The ideal place to begin is with a simple
joint, such as
a joint C, where the ratio RC can be already been determined and there are only two unknown. The forces of FCB and SCD, FX equals 0 and FY equals 0 rules can be used to evaluate both. There are three unknown forces at joint E, FEA, FEB, and FED, which may result in more complicated solution and then unknown values. Joint B is chosen to the testing region to demonstrate that the FX equals FY equals 0 equation leads to zero value FX equals FY equals 0. The state of the member should be clearly stated whether it's under tension, positive or compression negative.
I move to the
second one, method of section for thrust analysis. When determining the force in all components of a thrust, the section technique is the effective method. When only a few member forces of a thrust are required, the method of section is the shortest way to determine these forces. An imaginary cutting line termed a section is drawn across stable and determined thrust in this manner. As a result, a piece divides the thrust into two halves. Because the entire thrust is balanced, any section of it must be balanced as well. To solve for member forces, any of the two portions of the thrust can be examined. And in the two equations of equilibrium, Fx equals 0, Fy equals 0, and Mx equals 0 can be used.
The specific
will be the same as the previous figure with the two alternative support provides. Using the same simple thrust model, unlike the combined technique, we can solely concentrate with determining the force value for member BC, EC, and ED. A few simple rules to follow. First, pass the segment of the thrust through a maximum of the three members, one of which a desired member, separating the thrust into the two fully different parts. Second, take movement about the place at the joint where the two members connect at the one part of the thrust and solve for the member force using M equals 0. Then, using the equilibrium equation for thrust, solve the other two unknown using Fx equals 0 and Fy equals 0. A virtual cut in thrust allow member VC, ED, and ED which are only recruit members. To begin, the RA and RB support ratio must be identified. Again, strong judgment is necessary to solve this dilemma, which a simple solution is considered either the left or the right side. Comparing joint C to the joint virtual point, taking movement of joint E virtual point clockwise throughout the entire RH section will be considered easier. The LHS part. The point of movement can be then in either joint D or C or the joint technique can be used to option the other's member for skate for FCB, FCE, and FDE.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Saifuddin bin Ahmad Karahi and my matrix number is AA211411. Today, I will talk about the analysis and calculation. We have two calculation, which is the first one is method of joint and the second one is method of section. So, the first calculation is method of joint. Lihat daripada soalan, kita akan ada dua fakta, iaitu all members 1 meter long and all angles are 60 degree. So, kita tahu setiap palang tersebut panjang ialah 1 meter dan angle di situ ialah 60 degree. Dan kita akan ada satu force iaitu 200 Newton di point D dan daya itu menghala ke bawah. So, mula-mula sekali kita akan buat FBD. FBD tersebut telah dilukis dan apa yang kita nampak di point A kita akan ada AX dan AY dan di point E kita ada EY. Daripada FBD tersebut, kita buat jumlah FX dengan jumlah FY. So, jumlah FX sama dengan AX sebab kat situ ada satu je AX dan dia sama dengan kosong. Jumlah FY sama dengan negatif 200 Newton plus AY plus EY. So, kita nak dapatkan satu nilai iaitu nilai EY. So, kita nak dapatkan nilai EY, kita perlu point di A dan guna teknik moment. Moment ialah force direct and distance. So kita akan ada satu force iaitu 200 Newton dan dengan 1.5. Kalau kita kira daripada D ke A ialah 1.5 meter. Dan kita tolak dengan EY sama dengan 2. Sebab apa 2? 2 palang tersebut mewakili dah 2 meter. So bila kita dapat, bila kita kira EY sama dengan 150 Newton. So, seterusnya EY kita telah dapat dan kita masukkan dalam equation jumlah FY. So, jumlah FY sama dengan negatif 200 Newton plus AY plus EY. EY kita telah dapat 150 Newton dan daripada equation tersebut kita akan dapat AY dan AY ialah 50 Newton. Seterusnya kita analisis setiap point. So, the first point is point A. Apa yang kita dapat? AY ialah tadi ialah 50 Newton. So kita lukis kat situ AY ialah 50 Newton. Dan kita akan ada dua force AB dengan AC. So daripada point tersebut kita akan gunakan teknik total force. So total force for Y is 0. So 0 equal to 50 plus FAB sin 60. So apa kita guna FAB? Sebab daripada AB tu kita boleh dapat nilai Y dan nilai X. So kita nak Y, so kita guna C60. So force AB sama dengan negatif 50 bahagi 0.866 dan kita akan dapat force AB sama dengan negatif 57.7 Newton compression. Sebab apa compression? Sebab dia negatif. Okay, seterusnya kita akan gunakan jumlah FX. Jumlah FX sama dengan kosong. Kosong sama dengan FAB cos 60 plus FAC. Kita boleh guna FAB cos 60 sebab daripada AB kita boleh dapat dia punya X. Cos sama adjacent. So FAB cos 60 plus FAC. So FAB kita telah dapat kat atas negatif 57.7. Kita masukkan. So negatif 57.7 dan cos 60 tambah FAC. So kita akan dapat force untuk AC sama dengan 28.85 Newton. Dari lah tension sebab dia positif. Okay, seterusnya ialah point B. Daripada point B, kita boleh dapat force untuk AB, force untuk BC dan force untuk BD. So, kita guna jumlah untuk FY. Force Y yang terlibat ialah force AB dengan force BC. Force AB kita telah dapat tadi negatif 57.7 Newton. Dan kita boleh cari force BC. Kita masukkan dalam equation, jumlah FY sama dengan kosong. Kosong sama dengan force AB sin 60 tolak FBC, force BC sin 60. Sebab apa dia sin? Sebab dia nak Y. So kosong sama dengan force AB dah dapat 57.7 sin 60 tolak force BC sin 60. So force BC sama dengan 57.7 Newton tension. Seterusnya ialah jumlah FX. Kita gunakan FX sebab kita nak dapatkan untuk force BD. Tapi force AB dan force BC kita kena gunakan sebab punya degree. So dia mempunyai x dan y, dan kita boleh gunakan dia untuk mencari jumlah x. So cos kita masukkan dalam equation, kosong sama dengan force AB cos 60 plus force BC cos 60 plus force BD. So kosong sama dengan 57.7 cos 60 plus 57.7 cos 60 plus force BD. So kita nak cari force BD. Force BD sama dengan negatif 28.85 plus 28.85, dan kita akan dapat dia negatif 57.7 Newton compression. So dekat point C, kita akan ada 4 daya, iaitu force AC, force BC, force CD dan force CE. Untuk force Y, kita boleh gunakan dengan force BC dengan force CD sebab dia boleh cari force Y. So kosong sama dengan force BC C60 tambah dengan force CD C60. Kita telah dapat tadi nilai force BC iaitu 57.7, dan kita nak boleh masukkan, dan kita akan dapat force CD sama dengan negatif 57.7 Newton compression. Seterusnya lah jumlah force untuk X. Jumlah force untuk X, kita kena gunakan semua daya sebab semua daya mempunyai arah untuk X. So kita masukkan dalam equation, kita akan dapat negatif force AC tolak force BC cos 60 tambah force CD cos 60 plus force CE. So kita telah masukkan nilai, dan kita akan dapat force CE sama dengan 86.55 Newton, dan dia ialah tension. Okay, seterusnya lah di point D. Point D kita akan ada 3 force yang attached to point D, iaitu force BD, force CD dan force DE. Sekarang ni kita telah ada 2 nilai, iaitu force BD dan force CD. So kat sini saya gunakan jumlah force Y sama dengan kosong. So kita masukkan di dalam equation yang berkaitan, iaitu force CD dengan force DE. Sebab apa guna FY, lagi satu ada tambahan force iaitu 200 Newton daripada atas ke bawah. So kosong sama dengan force CD C60 tolak 200 tolak force DE C60. Force DE sama dengan negatif 150 bagi 0.866, dan kita akan dapat force DE sama dengan negatif 173.2 Newton, dan ialah compression. Seterusnya ialah point E. Di point E, kita telah dapat nilai force DE dan force CE. So kalau kita masukkan dalam equation untuk jumlah force Y dan jumlah force X, ia akan tetap sama, iaitu kosong sebab kita telah dapat nilai di setiap each of members. Itu sahaja daripada saya. Terima kasih. So the second calculation is method of section. All members is 1 meter long and all angles are 60 degree. Dalam gambar aja tersebut, kita mempunyai dua force, iaitu 2 kilonewton di point C dan 3 kilonewton di point I. Mula-mula kita akan membuat daripada FBD. Macam biasa, di point A ialah kita akan dapat AX dan AY, dan di point K kita akan dapat satu force, iaitu force KY. So jumlah FX sama dengan AX sama dengan kosong. So jumlah FY kita boleh dapat AY plus KY, kita tolak dengan 2, tolak dengan 3 sama dengan kosong. Sebab apa tolak 2 dan tolak 3? Kita ada dua force, iaitu 2 kN dan 3 kN di point C dan point I. So untuk dapatkan nilai AY dan KY di equation di atas, kita gunakan prinsip moment. Daripada prinsip moment, force direct distance sama dengan moment. So daripada point C 2 kN, kita darab dengan 1 sebab jarak dia daripada A ke C ialah 1 meter. Seterusnya di point I, kita ada 3 kN dan jarak daripada A ke I ialah 4 meter. Seterusnya ialah KY. Jarak KY daripada A ke K ialah 5 meter. So kita masukkan dalam equation KY, kita akan dapat 2.8 kN. Setelah kita dapat KY, kita boleh masukkan nilai dia dalam jumlah FY, dan kita akan dapat force AY, dan force AY sama dengan 2.2 kN. So berdasarkan soalan, kita perlu ada 3 nilai, iaitu force FH, force FG dan force EG. So kita akan nampak pemotongan, iaitu di palang FH dan palang EG. Mula-mula apa yang nilai yang kita boleh cari ialah force FG. So kita akan gunakan FY dan jumlah FY, dan jumlah FY sama dengan kosong. Kita masukkan dalam equation, kosong sama dengan 2.2 sebab kita dah ada nilai AY. Lepas tu kita tolak dengan 2, kita dah ada nilai nilai Y DC, nilai force yang menghala ke bawah DC dan tolak dengan force FGC 60. Setelah itu kita akan dapat force FG sama dengan 0.231 kN dan ialah tension. Seterusnya kita boleh mencari di force FH. Untuk mencari di force FH, kita kena gunakan prinsip moment. So kita masukkan nilai yang kita dapat. So kita masukkan nilai force yang ada untuk mencari moment. So kita masukkan nilai force yang ada di equation moment untuk mendapatkan force FH. So mula-mula kita akan dapat. So moment kita ialah clockwise. Di point C, positif 2 darab 1 sebab jarak A ke C ialah 1 meter. Seterusnya ialah force FG C60 dan 2.5 meter. Dan seterusnya force FG cos 60 darab dengan 0.866 meter sebab dia tinggi F ke A ialah 0.866 meter. Dan seterusnya force FH dan 0.866 juga. So kita akan setelah kira dan kita akan dapat force FH sama dengan negatif 3 kN compression. Untuk mencari force EG, kita kena gunakan jumlah force untuk X. So kosong sama dengan EG plus FH plus FG cos 60. So kosong sama dengan force EG tambah FH, tapi nilai dia ialah negatif 3. Kita akan gunakan dia ialah negatif 3. So kita akan tambah dengan force FG cos 60. Force FG sama dengan 0.231 dan C60 ialah 0.5 dan kita akan dapat force EG sama dengan 2.885 kN dan dia ialah tension. Itu saja daripada saya. Terima kasih.
Hello, my name is Muhammad Ali Farhami Jamil and my matrix number is AA211882. Okay, for my part, I will talk about discussion about our topic. With the component element stress largely in exile tension or compression, a truss provide a robust form capable of supporting significant external load over a broad span. Individual parts meet at truss joints, also known as spanel points. The top and bottom chart are the connect section that comprise the top and the bottom of the truss, respectively. Okay, that's all from me. I will pass to next presenter. Thank you.
In conclusion, the truss is a construction invention that describes a weight of a roof to the exterior walls for the winter support. Try to provide more support and help users to utilize fewer materials to complete any project. It will for load dispersals. It extends the average lifespan of the any structure, such as bridge of a building. Trusses have a significant drawback as well. If truss bridge take up more space and can be a more distraction to the driver at time. It also necessitates more frequent maintenance of a joint and fit, as well as more calculation to ensure that it can be withstand the maximum loads. The method of joint and the method of section are used to determine the force in the member. As a result, we might conclude that the force assists each member at each joint. Trusses have an important function in our environment, such as bridge, buildings, rooftop, and among other things. That's all for me. Thank you.